One of the biggest drawbacks to surgery, or one of the biggest hindrances to people getting surgery, is the fact that there's a lot of misinformation about surgery in general out there. A lot of times I've had patients come to me and they say their primary doctor or their neurologist said that, you know, you'd become paralyzed, you'll be blind, you can become a zombie if you have surgery, and all these things, you know, and I kind of understand where they come from, because maybe there was a history of maybe they referred to a patient and there was a bad outcome, and so they kind of have a hesitation to doing that. But really the thing I want to emphasize is that nowadays epilepsy surgery is very safe. The benefits far outweigh the risks with the surgery. People do very well, and it's one of the few things we can do to actually cure someone of in neurosurgery. The main benefits of epilepsy surgery in general are that, you know, obviously number one is becoming seizure free. Depending on the area of the seizure, where the seizures come from, depending on the, like, lots of patient specific characteristics, the rates of seizure freedom vary between 50% and 80%. I always tell the patients, is obviously nothing is 100% guaranteed, but a lot of the times, especially if they have a lesion on their MRI, if they have some other, if all the non-invasive tests point towards one area specifically, those are patients that generally tend to do very well. The other part of this is that when a patient has failed 2 to 3 epilepsy medications, and by failure we mean, you know, either they have too many side effects or they continue to have seizures, they should be referred to a level 4 epilepsy center. The reason for that is that if you go to a level 4 epilepsy center, they can evaluate you not only for various other medications, but more importantly to see if you might be if the patient might be a surgical candidate. The benefits of the surgery, aside from seizure freedom, we know lots of studies have shown quality of life improves, you know, depression scores improve, just overall people tend to, you know, if we can make someone seizure free, those patients generally tend to have a, you know, better outcome than those that aren't.